ignorance brought you here, sister. To the one place where your talents are free to grow and be truly feared.
Still, the Karui barbarians advance upon us. Lainai is dead, his legion slaughtered along with every eternal man, woman, and child from Lainai's watch to the foot of our axiom. Should the need arise, we shall retreat through Prisoner's Gate, raising my barricade behind us. Yet our salvation is at hand. Foul times demand heroic deeds, and through my arts, our Lord Brutus will arise anew to defend us. May the dry sands quench their thirst with Karui blood when our mighty warden delivers his judgment upon them.
My loyal Declan, give our Lady Piety your absolute support and watch her with absolute scrutiny. There is much to learn from the likes of the Inquisitor, the Umbra, and the Soulless One. I would hate for Piety to feel that she needs to shoulder such perilous wisdom alone. Dominus.
My creation, brute. You'd not have fallen so easily.
Chevron. Dear Chevron. You have certainly had your work cut out for you with Lionel's Legion. Do not concern yourself with Marseilles' complaints. Our Emperor is fully aware of the General's fickle nature. As to your need to accelerate the implantation process, I can recommend a quite simple alteration. Dip the gem in a boiling solution of 6 parts blood and 1 part thormetic sulfite for no more than 13 seconds. Any longer, and you invite the crystals wrath. Once the gem is withdrawn from the solution, you have but a few seconds to install the gem in the prepared flesh and close the wound. Should the gem cool too much prior to implantation, it will become inert, and your patient with it. Trust in that bountiful talent of yours, Sharon. My thoughts are with you. Malachi.
The Warden's free of his own prison. Well, since you're so bloody determined to cheat the britches off death, you'd better have one of these, for luck. And when they write the song about you, just be sure to mention that it was Tarkley who taught you everything you know.
for your own good.